Seed starting indoors is a great way to get a jump on the growing season, especially if you live in a northern climate like me. But you can do this anytime to start your own flower or vegetable plants. First, let's talk about what they'll grow in. Miracle-Gro Seed Starting Potting Mix is a ready-to-use, lightweight, premium mix, excellent for germinating seeds. It's specially formulated for fast root development. Look how fine this is, a great place for starting little seeds. Another great tip when starting seeds is to think small. Once they get established, you can transplant them into larger containers. Shallow is also very good. You can use small pots, eggshells, or even egg cartons, but again, start small. This is a tray I picked up at a local garden center, and it's really perfect for starting seeds. And you don't have to start this many at once. You can even break it up into six packs. I also have a drainage tray and a clear plastic cover that will make a little mini greenhouse for starting these seeds. To determine when to start your seeds, refer to your seed packets and get to know your frost date and growing zone. The U.S. Department of Agriculture has a detailed map showing plant hardiness zones ranging from cold to warm. I live in zone 6B and my last frost date is estimated to be right around April 30th, so I count back from there. Now fill your trays with mix and add the seeds as directed on the packet. It's usually a good idea to put 3 seeds per square. And now give them a gentle soaking. You want to make sure that the mix is thoroughly wet, but be careful not to dislodge the new seeds. You'll later remove 2 of the seedlings, letting the strongest get all the energy to grow. I know, I have a problem pulling out those little plants that I started too, but don't feel too guilty. You'll be rewarded with a better single plant down the road. Don't forget to mark what you plant, either with a tag or with a piece of tape and a permanent marker. It'll avoid confusion in the weeks to come. This next step is optional, but I think it's key to success. This is a great little grow light that allows me to lower the light all the way down to the plants. This keeps the light just above the plants in the tray and allows me to lift it every couple inches above the plants as they grow. Keep an eye on moisture level and don't let them dry out. A water bottle with a sprayer is a great way to keep them moist without flooding. Part of the Miracle-Gro family of products.